Hi, and welcome to a bite-sized tutorial. In this one, we will have a look at a timer node in Godot. A timer can have several use cases, such as delaying or repeating actions, triggering events, and UI updates. Something you find in many games are cooldowns, which of course are really simple to do in Godot. Let's first look at what I'm starting off with. I am using my character from my last video, which has been set up with movement and made into a scene. You won't, however, need any of this to grasp the concept of timers, so let's open up the input actions and add a new one. Project, project settings, and then the input map tab. I will call this one action primary and listen for input by clicking the plus symbol here. Now, assign your left mouse button by clicking the field here that says listening for input and then click OK down here. To keep this simple, I will create a node to act as an input listener by selecting my player node and clicking on the plus symbol up here, or by tapping the control key or command on Mac and A. If you have a sprite to use, feel free to add a sprite 2D node instead. Name it something simple. I'll just go with weapon because I would most likely use a cooldown in a weapon. Add a new script to it by clicking this button up here, next to the three dots. Start off with a variable up here of type boolean. Var is ready, the type, and the value, true. Let's now add a process method to start listening for the input. If input with a capital I is action just pressed, and within parentheses and quotation marks, action primary. This action we are listening to here is the left mouse button we assigned in the input actions. Now, let's type print with a message like action pressed and hit play. Every time we click the left mouse button, we should see the message action pressed in the console. But we don't want to be able to fire without a cooldown. So let's first add our boolean here by adding the keyword and, followed by is ready. Now, when we fire our weapon and the weapon is ready, we should set the boolean to false, because our weapon will no longer be ready. If I were to run this project now, fire the weapon and try to fire again, the code would stop here because is ready is now false. So, let's create a timer that resets the boolean back to true after a while. In the scene tree, create a new node as you did before, but search for timer and click create. Name it cooldown timer and, with the node selected, have a look at the inspector to the right. For this, I will leave the time on 1 second and make it a one shot, meaning the timer will stop as soon as it reaches 0. And the timer doesn't have to start automatically. In your script, the easiest way to reference your timer node in the process method is to drag the node into the script here. You could also type a dollar sign followed by the name of the node, just like this. Continue with a tiny dot followed by the start method to actually start the timer. Now, every time we fire the weapon, as long as we're allowed to, as decided by this boolean, we start the timer that will eventually set the weapon as ready again. Select a timer node in the scene tree and click on the node tab up here, next to inspector. These are the signals available to this node, basically events. So let's have a look at the top one here, timeout. When the timer reaches 0, this is the signal that gets emitted. To connect this to a method, you can double click on it and in the pop-up, make sure the root node that the script is attached to is selected, which you see here. The name of this method is good and self-explanatory, so click connect and you will see a new method in your weapon class. The only thing this has to do is set the boolean back to true, meaning once the time we defined in the timer has elapsed, the weapon is ready again. So, to summarize this, when we press the primary action button and the weapon is ready, we unready the weapon and start the timer. Once the timer is done, after a second as defined in the node, we ready up the weapon again. And there you have it, yet another something made super simple in Godot. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.